Hey there! Welcome to WORDZONE. I'm Ritwik and I'm going to demonstrate you my final year capstone project, which I made while I was doing BTECH in information technology. WORDZONE is basically a platform which lets user to execute multiple word-related queries, and while doing so, they generate some data. WORDZONE also uses that data to suggest them new words to learn, because the data that they generate clearly reflects their vocabulary. I've divided WORDZONE into four zones as of now: find zone, understand zone, knowledge zone, and learning zone. But before I dive into the each zone, let me talk about the tech stack that I've used. I've used Python for the base language because I'm using NLP related queries and machine learning model as well, which goes really smooth with Python. Moreover, there are many libraries like spell check and pronunciation, which I used in this project as well. I've used KIVY for the GUI because tkinter, as much as people might debate that it has improved in the recent years, still didn't look that good to me. So KIVY, here we come. For a standardized, nice GUI look, I know I'm not that good in the GUI section, but still, KIVY was my choice because it also lets me convert my project into a APK. So yeah, that's why KIVY. And for the machine learning model, I've used LSTM because I have univariate data, which is time series as well. Because over a period of time, the vocabulary of the user will increase. So hence, we have univariate time series data. And for that, I'm using LSTM. Now, let's dive into the zones. First up is find zone, and as the name suggests, it is a place where people can find words that they are looking for. So let's suppose I'm a poet and I'm stuck and I want a word which should be rhyming to something and have a meaning with something. Then I'll just dive into the rhymer dictionary. I'll enter the word that I want the rhyming words to be rhyming with, and then I'm asked if I want the answers to be related to some other word. I say yes, and I say my words should be related to literature. So WORDZONE would return me the words that are rhyming with light and have a meaning related to literature. However, if I wanted the words without any particular meaning, I could have said no and received a whole list of words which are rhyming to light. Next up is word crossword helper. We all love to play crossword, but once in a while it gets a real pain in the head if you're stuck. And taking hints doesn't harm. So here we go. If we have a single word which doesn't have any crossings, we can directly go and enter the descriptions and the length. We enter submit and we receive a set of results. Now we can further down narrow the results by specifying the alphabet and its position, which is fixed, and we get the results. However, if we have a word which is crossing with another word, then we enter the two word section, we enter the description, we enter the position, shared position, as in where they are crossing. Let's say it is crossing in first position, the length is 3, next description is unchanged, shared position is 1 again, and the length is 6. When I submit it, I get a result. And I've used this for solving a few crosswords, and I'm getting correct results. So yeah, it's working. So I get multiple things as answer, all possible answers. But for the crossword that I'm solving, this first result is true. So that was all about crossword helper. Next up is Scrabble helper. We love to win in Scrabble, so cheating comes naturally to us. Yes, I am a cheater. So I made the Scrabble helper where I enter a word fragment, let's say rate, and I want to win real bad, so I'll specify the length to be 10, and I can also enter a position, let's say 5. When I submit it, I get a list of words which have rate in 5th position, and the whole word has a length of 10. So this was all about find zone. I'm going to open source the code so that more features can be added subsequently in the future. But as of now, I just felt the need of these three. Next up is understand zone. Here I can enter a word and I can submit it. However, I have implemented this across the app that if ever I enter a wrong spelling, then I'm prompted that there were no meanings for the given word. So go back and try one of these words. So since I entered a wrong spelling, instead of U, I typed in O. So now I'm given a correct spelling, and I'll just enter the correct spelling. Okay, I missed here as well. And I submit it to receive the definition and example. Now the fun part about understanding zone is that if a word has multiple meanings, it gives me multiple meanings with examples. So ace can be ace of diamonds, ace can be a person who excels at a particular sport, and ace can be a service as well. An ace can be a person who has no sexual feelings or desires. So yeah, this is how the understand zone works. It gives me a definition, each possible definition along with example, so that the user actually understands the word. Third up is the knowledge zone. Here we have synonyms, antonyms, hyponyms, and hypernyms. I don't feel the need to go and type in and show you all the things, because I guess you know what a synonym, what an antonym and is. Let me just tell you what hyponym, hyponym, and holonym are. So let's say I enter red. So a hyponym is basically a superset. So red is a chromatic color. So a chromatic color is a hyponym of red. A chrome red or crimson or dark red are subsets of red. So it comes under hyponym. Holonym, however, shows a part of relationship. So trunk is a holonym of tree. Arm is a holonym of body. Likewise, since red doesn't have a part of relationship with any word, we don't see any holonyms there. So this was the knowledge zone. Now, before talking about or entering into learning zone, let me tell you how am I training the machine learning model. I have used frequency of a word in English language as its level of toughness. I know this might not be a hard truth, because there might be words which have a lot of prefixes and suffixes and are very less used in English language, but the meaning can be quite clear. So I know this is not the perfect plan I've got here, but yeah, it works pretty fine, because naturally if a word has a frequency which is very less in English language, then the user might not know that word. Since I have three different zones, I can clearly say that in find zone, user is entering words that they know, that they use to describe things. So that would I'm using those words and those frequencies to train a low-level model. Understand zone, however, deals with the words which the user doesn't know and really wants to know the answer. So understand zone covers the crisp golden area that we actually want to cover. So I'm using those words to train a medium level model. However, in the result section of each of the find zone and knowledge zone, we might find words which are not that common for the user. So let's say we found indict in rhyming words. This is not common. So we are going to store the words which have high toughness, and I'm using those words to train a high level model. I'm using LSTM, as I've already told. So that is how my learning zone works. So I have low words, medium words, and high words. Low words would be based on my search quality, the words that I actually enter in find zone. So these will be very simple. And since I haven't used this a lot, I mean, with a lot of data, the models will become even better and clearer. So I'm getting a word like different for the low level. If I go to the medium words, I will get a bit tougher word than different. I get deployment, and let me cross my fingers because this might not work correctly, but let's see what we get in high words. Okay, we get reload. Now, again, as I said, this is having a prefix, and that's why maybe the frequency of this word is very less in English language, but we can understand the meaning. But again, let me blame the lack of data to get away from this. So yeah, that's pretty much. I know this is a naive project, but a lot can be done and a lot improvements can be brought in. That is why I'm going to open source this project soon. It will depend on your views as well. So let me know what views you have and what suggestions you have got, or any queries. Ping me, you can DM me on LinkedIn or comment here and let me know what you think about it. Thanks.